Ministry of Foreign Affairs said Sri Lanka mission in Tehran is presently coordinating with the relevant authorities in Azerbaijan to repatriate the remains of the three students who were killed in a fire in the foreign country.
Three Sri Lankan university students aged 21, 23 and 24 studying at Western Caspian University in Baku, Azerbaijan died at their apartments as a result of suffocation from smoke inhalation due to a fire that had occurred on the 9th of January. The three Sri Lankan students had left to Azerbaijan in August last year. Foreign media reported that the three students had died due to inhaling poisonous gas that was released from a fire that had erupted in the basement of the two-storied house they occupied in the area of Beyil in Baku. Foreign media added the reason for the fire was a default in an electronic equipment, and the police and fire brigade of Azerbaijan are conducting further investigations into the incident. The deceased have been identified as residents of Kaduela and Piliandala. Two of the victims, one named Malsha Sandeepani and the other Taruki Amaya, aged 23 and 21 respectively, are members of the same family and residents of Bokundara Piliandala. It's been reported that the sister of the father of the two victims has also passed away due to a heart condition.
This lady is the sister of the father of the two daughters. She couldn't bear the unfortunate news about these two girls. She cried and then complained of chest pains.
24-year-old Amodya Madhu Hansi Jayakodi, another student who fell victim in Azerbaijan, is a resident of Lower Bomiria, Kaduela.
She went for higher education in Azerbaijan. She spoke to me that evening as well. She was very happy. All we know is that they had died after suffocating inside their room.
When news first inquired, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Sri Lanka said the Sri Lanka mission in Tehran is presently coordinating with the relevant authorities in Azerbaijan to repatriate the remains of the three students. Meanwhile, during a media briefing today, Minister of Higher Education, Dr. Bandula Gunawardana, expressed the following views in this regard.
We convey our condolences to the bereaved families. Because of the barrier that exists within the local education system in the country, students have to go out of their way to obtain a degree. I hope to design a system to monitor the institutions that send students overseas for higher education. As a long-term approach, we must try to retain these students in the country. Only 30,000 students are absorbed every year to the local university system. Parents spend millions and send their children overseas. I have made a proposal to the government. I have requested for a large plot of land, where we will establish internationally accepted universities. The same benefits provided for the Board of Investment will be provided to this zone as well. One foreign student will spend five times of what is spent by a tourist. Imagine how much they could spend for a period of 2 to 3 years.
The unfortunate state of the school education and university education system at present is one of the many examples that prove the government's failure to develop the education system in Sri Lanka. While parents spend their entire fortune on national schools with the intention of providing a proper education to their children, the rural school system in Sri Lanka has weakened due to government's failure to allocate sufficient funds for their development. Though Sri Lanka prides itself over the concept of free education, at present students are compelled to fulfill their educational needs through tuition. However, the standards of Sri Lanka's education system remains very low compared to global educational standards. Dilapidated schools and dilapidated sports equipment is no surprise to many children in Sri Lanka. Parents who fail to admit their children to a national school resort to admitting them to international schools. Students deprived of opportunities in local universities, leaving for privately funded overseas education is a common sight at present. While the future generation of our motherland continues to struggle with their future, the politicians in our country continue their struggle to achieve their narrow political objectives. It has now come to the point where people are defrauded and lured into sending their children for substandard overseas educational institutions.